Hello, everyone. Good afternoon. My name is Luft from Club Pero. I'm the new reporter of Yokoso News. Hello.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
This is Katz from Yokoso News, yokosonews.com. Yokoso News is the online website to introduce Japanese culture in English so that you can understand Japan more. But, you know, this is the get into the regular habit of disaster update. So we are at the Club Pero. In a DINGO place, the dog training facility. So you will hear some dog barking. However, you know, so today I'm here in the Yokohama, Japan, and then we, you know, somehow I was gonna do something really quick and easy broadcast, but somehow we have a professional cameraman. Yes, Marume-san is operating the camera, and wow. Then Shu-san from our live concert from 2 days ago to operate the sound again. Thank you very much. Yeah, so let me introduce you guys again. First of all, Luft.
Luft, yay!
Luft.
He's a Samoyed, 4 years old.
I am Samoyed. I'm 4 years old. Ooh. I like barking.
Yeah, then Kazu-san from DINGO. He's
Founder
of DINGO.
Yes.
It's the professional dog training certificate that goes international too. And then next, we have Mika-san from DINGO. You are?
I'm nothing. Okay. I'm nothing from DINGO. I'm part of DINGO. But
okay.
Yes, I'm just a partner.
Partner of Kazu-san.
Yes.
Yes. And she can speak English like more than I am, so that's why
I don't think so.
Yeah.
He's a liar.
Anyway, so
yes.
Actually,
thank you very much for coming.
Thank you very much for having me this week.
It's a pleasure.
Yes, yeah. As we know, as you might know, I've been broadcasting the disaster update, weekly update, for about almost
month?
3 months.
3 months.
3 months, yes. Now.
I think you spent the whole month broadcasting every day.
Yeah. And then if you,
then
come back to weekly. But if you remember the first night, I made a phone Skype call to
Mika.
Them.
Yeah.
And
yes,
then,
that's right.
And then she explained to us what happened to Yokohama on the day off.
That was the
blackout.
First. Yes.
Yeah, after, and then you guys waited for the blackout, and some of the students of this facility got stuck.
Yes.
And
yes.
She had to stay here and stuff.
That's
too, right?
And explained all about it to you on the Skype.
Yeah. So you know, then 4 days before the earthquake, I came here.
Yes, was here.
Yeah, I came here to broadcast the Yokoso News Weekly called Pets in Japan. You can check, you can search on yokosonews.com, or you can come to YouTube of youtube.com/yokosonews to find the archive. And you guys explain to us what to expect to have a pet in Japan and stuff. So, you know, just the really easy way. Then 4 days after, earthquake happened and everything kind of changed. So today we will do some weekly update to talk about what has happened between the June 29th to July 5th. But I'm going to cut those little bit short because I'm going to today, since I'm in Tokyo, because I was at the charity concert 2 days ago, Music for Charity for Miyagi. If you come to yokosonews.tv or lanternmusic.net, there's a donate button. You can still donate your money. We will continue to accept the donation for a while. I'm planning to do it for about 6 weeks. To do the fundraise. Then I really want to go to North Japan one day to report what's going on in Ishinomaki area with the Grace City Church Tokyo, the church that has been organizing weekly trip to Ishinomaki and Koganehama Ishinomaki. So that, but you know, I don't want to you know, ask church to give me money. So, but at the same time, I've been broadcasting for free for like 3 months, and I'm kind of start getting out of fun doing this. So I kind of have to start asking for the donation. So that's why I'm doing the fundraiser. So anyway, so that's why I did the Music for Charity concert. The archive is available to watch. And then, so you can enjoy the music, and if you like the music, that what we do, and if you support the disaster broadcast, then you could maybe, hopefully, you could contribute. But if you don't have, you know, you don't have to have, you know, if you don't are like running out of little bit of the fun, you don't have to do it. I mean, just keep watching the show, please, so that we can keep the attention to the North Japan, because that's what people want now, that we need to keep attention to the North Japan, then so that they will, you know, most thing that we are afraid of is the people going to lose, people start feeling lonely, that we want to prevent from happening, because people in North Japan had a great mentally damaged, and then but we need to we won't really mentally support them. So if you cannot donate, that's okay, but if you could help me spread the word. Oh, I was gonna wear my contact lenses. Shoot.
It's okay. That's okay. You look wonderful. You just look wonderful.
Okay, thank you. But so today I'm not really going to do much of the weekly update. But let me quickly go over what happened between last week and this week. For example, in North Japan right now, Aoyagi-san from a Grace City Church also mentioned it during the our concert 2 days ago too. But it's getting summer, so we start having the concern of the food poisoning, more public health issue, more flies start flying around. So we need to bug spray to kill specifically and stuff. That's what they told me. So we have a report from Yomiuri that we need, many people try to buy those bug spray or what the bug swingers to kill the bug and stuff. So that's what the report too. And then they Japanese government finally launched a I don't know, Fukosho. Do you know the English name of Fukosho? Reconstruction agency. Yeah. I have to confirm with the official English name. But they are getting ready to launch the reconstruction agency. So that's there. So then we are having the problem too, because we just had a breaking news that commissioner of reconstruction agency announced the resignation a couple of days after he was assigned to become a week within a week since the minister of the reconstruction.
Oh.
So he announced the resignation just now a couple hours ago because of the those. Anyway, so we had some kind of political disaster. I shouldn't say disaster, but the conflict. What else?
Do you know who is going to take the take his place?
We don't know yet. They just made an announcement just now. So, and what else? So I apologize, guys, because I was really busy to take care of the music charity concert 2 days ago, and then I was also on the Japanese Ustream show last night. More than 300 Japanese people watch how I started the Yokosu News disaster reporting. So I was kind of getting ready to those two major events, so I wasn't really doing the research. And then on July 1st, we have a report that at least 209 companies filed bankruptcy due to the disaster. According to Teikoku Data Bank, Imperial Data Bank, on July 1st. So 209 companies filed bankruptcy. So it is now getting to the, it's now kind of officially we could claim that the worst disaster in terms of the economy-wise too. That's including the hotels, company, manufacturer company, and stuff. And so Japanese government are trying to come up with the second budget plan bill. That's the focus of the second budget bill. Is the to revive the fishing industry. So that's the news from Yomiuri on July 3rd. According to Japanese government, the second budget fixed budget bill, they are going to budget for the to revive the fishing industry, especially for to reconstruct the fishing market and also ice manufacture, because in order to transport those fresh fish, you need the lots of ice, because many ice factory got damaged by tsunami. Some of the port restored some of the function because the ice manufacture was still damaged. They couldn't go back fishing. They couldn't accept the fisherman boat. So that's also the problem. That was the major kind of news for a week. I apologize that I wasn't really able to give you the detail research about that. Then let's go to the nuclear power plant incident. And as it's getting hot, the condition of the TEPCO contracting worker working on the Fukushima nuclear power plant, it's getting severe. So according to Yomiuri, on June 29th, 53 TEPCO workers had been sent to the hospital by any ill or injured. Up to June 29th. So in between March 14th to June 29th, three injury, including the cut, breaking bones, the 33 people were sent to the hospital by the injury and breaking bones. And seven people were sent to the hospital because of the heat stroke. And then also, some typical workers were sent to the mental hospital too, counseling, because of the, you know, but working under severe condition and stuff. And, you know, so including that 53 person, there is also one worker who died from the heart attack as well. And also the three workers who has been exposed high amount of the radiation, over 250 millisievert, which the Japanese government set the standard, kind of allowance for the workers. And so on the June 30s, a mega float from Shizuoka, Japan, those a big floating facility, they finally docked to the Fukushima nuclear power plant and start using it to preserve the start transporting those radioactive contaminated water onto those mega float. Mega float is the big concrete floating kind of the island that has the capability of the preserve the high contaminated amount of the water. Water inside, and then they typical bought it from Shizuoka Prefecture and transported to Fukushima nuclear plant. And then on June 30th, they start using that mega float to try to avoid more leakage, radioactive contaminated water leakage to the outside. And then again, according to Yomiuri, again on the June 30th, many Fukushima park, because it's getting summer, many of the grass start growing. So we actually need to cut those grasses, you know, to prevent, you know, to. But however, many part of the many parks in Fukushima, they didn't want to cut their grasses because they are worried about the radiation. So. That's also so park is getting start looking bad, you know, because the growing grasses. So it's one of the concern too. And then so after the so again, I think TEPCO. I think I also mentioned last week. New president of TEPCO was assigned to TEPCO, and then you know, so hopefully new management is going to be able to take care of this disaster. And then on July 1st, the civil rights group, the I don't know official English title is, but Kodomo Tachi o Hōsha no kara mamoru Fukushima Network is the Japanese English direct translation of their name is that network to protect children from the radiation. Mr. Nakate-san is the leader. On June 30th, they announced that they did conduct the random test to check their urine between 6 to 16 years old, 10 female male kids between 6 and 16 years old. And they said that they detect cesium-134 from 8 years old girl had a 1.13 becquerel per kilogram of the cesium-134 from her urine. And 7 years old boy, they had 1.3 becquerel per kilogram of cesium-137 from 7 year old boy. So you know, usually according to the leader Nakate-san, this civil rights group, usually the kids' urine shouldn't contain the radiation, but so this is obviously the effect by the this radioactive stuff. And when there is some improvement about, so they, I think on July 3rd, they finally completed, they finally finished making the complete circulation system of water filtering facility that TEPCO spent 50 billion yen to make. So again, when they are pouring the keep pouring the water onto the reactor to keep cooling down the reactor. However, because they, you know, they go through those fuel rod, melted fuel rod. So the water, and then there's a hole in the reactor. So all the contaminated water still leaking outside of the reactor. So the then we were really afraid of leaking lots of radioactive contaminated water, especially to the ocean. So TEPCO were trying to make it as much as possible, as soon as possible, to finish completing the making those oil water filtering facility. And on the afternoon of July 2nd, they kind of completed the circulation system. They filter those water to make it clean, radiation free, and send it back to the reactor to cool it. So they don't have to pour the new water and the increased amount of the contaminated water and stuff. So they finish making kind of that. Hopefully they had so much a problem with those radioactive filtering system. So hopefully, you know, it's gonna work out soon. And on July 3rd, the Ministry of METI, Kaieda-san, said that he will going to give the evacuees of Fukushima additional 300,000 yen as a part of the damage pay. So, you know, also, as you know, many of the residents of Fukushima evacuated from Fukushima, Japan to do those kind of stuff. I mean, then they lost the job, they might, they need money, obviously. Then the Japanese government is going to tell TEPCO that they should give additional 300,000 yen per person to the these evacuees. So in addition to the last ones. All right. Yeah, I forgot to broadcast the music. Can I do it? All right, here we go.
Music by Kevin MacLeod.
Okay, so anyway, now that's pretty much it. Really quick, update of did I miss something about the news? Ah, my feet! My feet is in sleep.
Mine's still okay.
Oh, yeah. Shoot.
You're not Japanese anymore, Hans.
Oh my god. So let me take a look at the timeline, everyone. Yeah, genetic fruitcake. Marco, what's up? And then Ace Man, hey, what's up, Ace Man? And Tatiana, what's up? And Zen, hello? Hey, Margie. Hey, it's been well, and Icarus.
Are they all from the States?
Yeah, pretty much. Okay. I think Maggie from, yeah. So, can you read some of the social timeline?
Well, I don't know which one to pick up. Marco, hello. cut, I get better news from you than any of the international news networks.
Thank you.
That's great.
Thank you. Yes. I'm happy, but...
Oh,
don't touch my feet.
Yeah. Do you know what it happens? Genetic fruitcake. July the 1st. That's usually the start of the fiscal calendar. Wonder if that was a factor.
Usually many Japanese company ends the fiscal year at the end of the March.
Mm. Yes.
So, but
that's not the case.
But many company do finish at the end of the June too. I think. I don't know, but
I don't know. They may do the quarterly.
Yeah, something like that.
Yes. And. Icarus factor?
Yeah.
What leaders are stand for?
Up to take his place and help. Yeah, that's 15, yes, 12 that's minutes ago about the Minister of the Reconstruction Agency. And then, yeah, he just announced the resignation. Maybe if I check the news, no, they haven't. Because they just announced the resignation, so they have.
It happened this morning, so we don't know.
Yeah, we don't know who's coming up. So, and Yoshi, hey, what's up? And then, yeah, they say that Japan is intoxicated and will be
for the next two years.
Yeah, I mean, I'm going to Tatiana. Yes, in and around Fukushima nuclear power plant, yes. I'm sure it's going to be intoxicated for a couple of years, especially in and around that nuclear power plant. However, like other side of the area, it shouldn't be that long. So, So Greece, you watching from Greece, Tatiana. Cool. So, when you coming out to this way?
This way, which way?
Ace Man, today I'm doing the special here at the Yokohama. So so that's it. So today is the kind of the special disaster update, Ace Man. Yeah, Ace Man, he lives in Shonan.
Oh, really?
Yeah, American guy living in Shonan.
Yes. So, come and visit us. Yes.
We are in Yokohama right now, so...
Particularly which area? Enoshima, Yokosuka... Well, we're neighbors then.
Yeah. Hey, Annette, good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, from Sweden. Watching.
Oh, good morning.
Good morning.
The Sweden, it's morning?
Yeah. Oh. I think so.
I see.
So, Mika-san.
Hi.
Let's talk about our Fujisawa, Ace Man.
What?
Ace Man Fujisawa.
Fujisawa. Oh, you're very close. Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Come visit us at some point.
We are live from Yokohama, Japan, DINGO, the dog training facility in Yokohama, Japan. And then, you know, they train dogs and other pets.
This is a dog training facility.
So Rufto is the our idol dogs. Right, Rufto?
Yes, I am. I am Rufto.
Well, we do some film dog training too. So I think he is used to the special setting, like the lights and camera, and he's used to his train to look at the camera.
Yeah.
Also, yes.
So I'm here because 2 days ago we had a charity event called Music for Charity for Miyagi.
Yes, I heard. Yes.
So I
heard it was very successful too.
It's produced by Lantern Music, April Parkinson, who lives in the Kawasaki, Japan.
Mm-hmm.
And then she put together the group of four bands and one dance group.
Oh.
And then try to raise the money. then I wanted to show the world that not only Japanese or famous celebrity, but local musician from the local community and local foreign community are trying to stand up and help the people of the North. They work together with Grace City Church Tokyo, the church which send the bus every week to the North Japan, and then to support. So that's what we are doing. And so you can still, if you come to yokosunews.tv or lanternmusic.net, you will be able to check out more information. And then since it's getting to the third month anniversary of the earthquake, I remember the first month or two, people are keep asking me, hey Katz, I want to donate, and I said no, because I
knew. So you didn't have any, you weren't prepared at
Yes. But because first month and second month, everybody donates. I know everybody feels, we are thankful.
That was everyone's attention.
Yeah, everyone donated.
Yes.
And so I knew that all the other people take care of that part. I know when the third month, people start forgetting about the disaster, then less money comes
in. Well, that means at the same time, the lives are life is getting back to
normal.
Kind of normal.
Normal.
Yes.
To the most of the people.
Yeah, to the most of the
if
people.
If the disaster is small, then it was okay.
Yeah.
It would be okay. However, again, from my weekly news that, you know, more than 300 companies filed bankruptcy.
Yes,
you know,
that's
so,
right. Well, the situation is still very serious.
Serious.
But at the same time, it means the lives is getting back to beginning to back normal. Yes.
So and then I think as a Yokoso News, as a regular media, I mean as a small scale media, I think we can kind of fill the gap between the major media and then regular people to bring you what kind of how we are reconstructing. I really want to show, so this knowledge you can get to learn it. I think this is like we as the day goes, we learn more. We learn more stuff. And then how we reconstruct ourselves, then we can use it for the future disaster in any kind too. So that's what I'm kind of doing right now. So this is the 43rd disaster update, number 43.
Really?
And then yeah.
So that means it's the 43rd week.
No. Because I broadcast every day for the first month.
Oh, I see. So that's
30 days.
The 30th.
Yeah, 30 days plus so the something like that.
13th week or something. Yes.
Jen, thank you. The concert was great. Thank you very much, Jen. And
over 300 Japanese companies filed bankruptcy,
filed
bankruptcy over the disaster.
Yeah, Aikara, thank you for rephrasing that. So,
yes.
So let's talk about ourselves, because I've been talking about what's major media been reporting, and since I'm in Tokyo, I did attend the concert, so I'm stopping by in Tokyo and Yokohama area. So that's why I came here, DINGO, because we did the Yokohama curry cooking contest September. Yeah. That's available on the archive. It's kind of boring though, because it's 3 hours long and everybody cooks, and I didn't make a highlight video. So, was the winner of the Yokohama curry?
Do you still remember?
I don't. Yeah,
well, you try to forget. It was me. It was me. I'm the best curry cooker.
Yeah, she cooked the best curry, and I think I have a curry after this show.
Yes, that's right.
Okay,
yes.
So I think I'm gonna eat some curry after this.
Yeah, to cheer you up. Yes.
And then last 4 days. It was a four days before March 11th. It was March 7th. I came here.
Yes, you came here.
Yeah, I came here. And then I came here too. Then broadcast about what to do to expect to keep the pets in Japan.
Mm. Yes.
Then we hang out and then leave. And 4 days later, then disaster happened.
Yes.
So what did you change?
Since then?
Yeah. But anyway. So you can watch the archive of disaster broadcast. If you scroll down yokosonews.tv, there's a link that goes to the archive. Then I think it's about 10 p.m. So I think it's like a second or third archive, I think, of the yokosonews disaster report. She joined me via Skype on the night of the March 11th. Soon after you guys got back the power, then you came on to the internet.
Yes. Well, the blackout started out just after the earthquake, and we didn't get the lights back until the 10.
About 10.
About 10. Yes. So we had to rely on Kazuya's creativity throughout the night. One of the things he did was to take the
LED
battery operated GPS. So that we can watch the
car navigation system.
Yeah, car navigation system. That's battery operated.
Which had one sig TV.
Yeah, TV. Yes. Tuner built in.
Yes, that was the only the news source available at that time, and that was very convenient. To see what happened. I know there was an earthquake, but nothing more than that was available at that time.
But food.
Yes.
We ate a lot at that time.
Yes. That's right. Yes.
Well, why?
We had nothing to do. So just we were thinking about food.
We actually, thanks to the American culture, we have some Costco here in Japan, and a few days before the earthquake, we went to Costco and we bought the big chunk of beef.
Yeah,
and we had that beef and
frozen
noodles, and also we thought in the blackout, we were so nervous. And the broadcasting on TV was reporting very, very, the serious part. So we were discussing, let's do something fun. We did some cooking.
Yeah.
We did some feast.
Then you also, because this is the dog training facility, you also on Skype, you told me something that, but what did you do to the dogs when the earthquake happened, and you guys had a mini aftershock.
We did was to stay calm. I think we are trained as a human, and we have to stay calm. Dogs mirror us. Dogs mirror us, so our feeding. So if we get nervous, dogs get nervous. So what we did was to when we felt the shake, we at the same time we fed the dog. We gave some treats. Just get the treats. And that's the way, the method of classical conditioning. The shake food. And that makes a good association. So that the dogs would feel that, oh, this is something good. Shake means food. So that's what we usually do. And as we usually do it, we could do that at on the big earthquake day too. So the dog weren't, we had about, how many dogs we had? Maybe six
or five,
including some staff's dogs. And we did the same thing as usual. And no dogs were scared of that. So they didn't have any aftershocks. I mean, they didn't have any
fear.
You know, the fear.
That's good. So, I mean, human being also, it's, you know, during the disaster too, of course, we tend to go panic. But
yes.
We must learn how
it.
To calm down so that we could prevent from further disaster. So once you start panicking
That's
and you start
right.
reacting stupid, then
yes.
then you create the man-made, the natural disaster becomes man-made disaster.
Yes.
So, but
yes, that's true.
So that's why we need to calm down during the disaster too. But same thing with the dog. You feed them when you shake, and then so it learned to calm
down.
Yeah,
the shake fun. I don't know if it's really a good thing because that's against the natural, you know, the fear. But we could change the dog's mind too.
Then, looking back, were any animal upset before the quake?
Well, not really.
Actually,
yet.
we have I said it during some broadcast earlier that according to some fishermen, kind of the fish, they were able to get a lot. They were able to catch a lots of particular kind of the fish.
So
before
they made
the earthquake,
some special movement.
Like they traveled in a different route because the earthquake was going to happen.
So the fisherman felt something is going to happen.
Yeah. Could too.
Could
so
happen.
Yeah. So yes. then yeah, I don't remember which particular fish, but around the Shikoku area they found the some
squid. I think.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Squid. Okay. Ace man. Thank you. Squid. So yeah, it was probably a squid. So yeah, then, and then I try so hard to stay up until the end of the concert. Okay. And then April made a comment. Hey, April, the producer of this event, down all the way
what?
Down. If your condition damn, then perhaps hard to say. Yeah. Anyway, it's good. So did the Luft, how was Luft when the quake happened? Did he scared?
No. Normal. He was just normal. Actually, we didn't concerned about our dogs at that time because daily training.
Well, I did the same thing to my bird.
Oh, your bird? Yes, your bird.
Yes, yeah. Well, sorry, Sarah's not here today because she's a big fan of cockatiels.
Yeah.
Sarah. Where are you today?
I think she started taking Japanese lesson.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Japanese.
Maybe she's
school.
Having Japanese lesson today.
Yeah, right now. Yeah, but that's the first day of the earthquake, and then what happened after in a couple days? What did you guys do?
Well, yes.
We put a filtering system of water.
Oh, yes, that's right. Yes.
It's a reverse osmosis system, the same as Fukushima's one. And what else? We bought a lot of batteries.
And also we offered some regarding the dog training thing. We offered some free seminars.
Yeah.
for how to react or how what to do under some emergent situation. So that's one of the things we did.
I see.
And we did it online, and also we did some face-to-face seminars.
So you pretty much taught them how to feed, how to condition the dog.
How to condition the dog, and also what to prepare when they want to, take the dog to the shelters or, you know.
How's crate training?
Crate training, that sort of things.
Oh, we had two plans to invite foreign speakers to Japan before earthquake.
Oh yes, that's right. And
one of them canceled to visit Japan. But the other one, who is a scientist, came to Japan after the earthquake. So we bought a so-called dosimeter.
Okay.
To give him, and he can check every day the radiation.
Yeah, so you had a guest from the foreign you had a foreign guest, and then in order to make him safe, you bought the dosimeter so that then he can check the radiation by himself every day. So that's good. Yeah, that's what we do too. You know, we try to do just as much information as possible. So yeah, so rest Raimi. Yes. Oh, hey! Who are you?
What?
And Inti Raimi is the Peruvian restaurant in Kawasaki.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's really great, the Peruvian food. That they also sponsor a charity concert 2 days ago.
Oh, good.
And we did the after pre-party and after private party among the staff at the Peruvian restaurant in Kawasaki.
Peruvian?
Yeah,
What kind of food?
Peruvian food. like a
what?
Meat and...
Well, that's meat.
Seafood.
Everywhere.
I mean, it's
what
on...
What kind of taste? Spicy or...
Yeah, it's somewhat spicy, you know. It's, and, you know, Kawasaki has a large population of the South American.
Oh, yeah.
So, they're there.
So,
too.
Do they eat a lot of corns? No, beans.
I love their potato dishes.
Oh.
Spicy, cheesy. Oh my God, I need to go to them again.
Yes.
I love that potato, cheesy, spicy food.
Really?
Oh my. Marume-san, you're from Kawasaki, desu yo ne? So the cameraman who's operating the camera for me, Marume-san is from Kawasaki too. So. Anyway,
yes,
oh my God, I'm getting hungry.
Yes, yeah. That's why. Yes. So
what happened after? So first couple of days, what's happened in Yokohama? What happened like couple of days? Like you, gasoline, food.
Gasolines are out. Water's out. And what
papers.
Else? Paper. Yeah, the toilet. Yes.
Curry time.
Yeah, curry time soon. Curry time very soon. Curry is waiting for us. Yes.
Papa. Yeah, Papa is the.
Papa la. Hua.
Yeah, Papa is the from that. Yeah, hey, Papa. Cool. Yeah, so. So, anyway. There were some shortage of food. Everybody tried to buy foods at supermarket.
Oh, yes, that's right. Yes, the
especially
rice.
Noodles.
Rice noodles and many of the convenience shops. Shelves were almost empty. And
my cigarettes.
Oh, your cigarettes. Yes, your favorite
today.
One.
They start selling again.
That was actually surprising to me. The earthquake made the cigarettes disappear. I didn't see any, you know, the connection or association between the earthquake and cigarette going out from the market. So that was actually surprising.
Many things are related with Fukushima.
Yeah, and what else? Natto, sticky beans, were also out of the market. Because that's not because of the sticky beans were out, but the package, many packages were made.
Films.
Yeah, are made, and films were made in that area. So that was the reason. So many things that I haven't ever thought about, you know, have any connection. Yeah. Well, really, there was a connection.
Yeah, but in a way, you know, we know that once, like during the Hanshin earthquake too, yogurt too, Aceman. Yes, yogurt, Aceman.
Ah, yeah. Yes. Yogurt.
They know very
and
well.
Milk. Yeah. Yes, they know more than we can. Yes.
Please tell us.
Yes. Well, we forget.
Yes,
all
he knew about the squid and yogurt.
Yeah, yeah. Yes. He watched our broadcast, so he's the one of the core listeners.
Good friend of
us. Oh, Aceman, you're not working right now? Okay. He teaches at the college and stuff. So I think he's off, I think, or something.
I see.
Yeah, then shortage. How long does those shortage last? How is it right now?
Well, it's back normal.
Almost
normal.
Except my cigarette.
It's okay. It's okay.
So important.
Off to work soon? Okay, Aceman.
Oh, yes.
Okay.
Well, the gas here in Yokohama, it lasted about a week, about 10 days.
Oh, yes.
Plus shortage.
Gas means gasoline?
Yes.
Gasoline.
Yes,
okay,
gasoline.
For the car.
Yeah, for the car. Petrol, yes. It lasted about.
So you had to wait for like a couple hours to get the gas, or don't sell it anymore?
Well, some shops were closed because they didn't have any gasoline. And some shops, even they were opened, there was a long line waiting. I think they had to wait about 2 hours three hours to get the gas. And still they had some limit, maybe up to 20 liters or something like that. That was really hard. I was so surprised that happened. But the one of the ladies that experienced the Hanshin explained to me a long time before this earthquake. Although she had car, she didn't have any gas filled up, so she couldn't move her car, drive her car. So that was actually really frustrating. She explained that to me from her experience. So we thought of the gasoline in our car right after the earthquake. So we went to the gas station on the following morning and filled up the gas.
So that time nobody was trying to.
No one was at the gasoline station. So we had no problems.
Filling up the gas. So you were able to come to Yokkaichi to continue your work.
Yeah.
Your trip.
That was actually how many days after the accident?
Well, a week after.
Week.
We visited you.
Yeah.
That's right.
Well,
yes.
It wasn't the broadcast, but we went to eat ramen. It was the first first time that I went out with somebody.
Out of the house.
Out of my office to meet someone not through the Skype.
I think we had a real conversation and stuff. Every time you do something, we are with you. Like we were at the opening of your studio, your broadcasting studio, and after you visited here, earthquake happened. And after the broadcasting, you know, for about a week, never resting. we had first the meal together. Yes.
So somehow, you know, we have a kind of connection together.
Yeah, special relationship.
I think so. So, and then you had to cancel the event, right? You were going to go to the big animal event.
Oh,
but
yes.
That has been cancelled.
Very good memory. Yes. Actually, Shu-san, our PA person today, was supposed to be help us in the big event.
And he also helped us to broadcast the Music for Charity concert 2 days ago.
That's right. I hope he's not sleeping.
And he doesn't understand English much, so we can say anything. But you had to cancel the event. Event got canceled, but they just postponed. Right? They're gonna come back, right?
Yes.
Next year.
Next
year.
Next March. Okay.
What is it called?
JPF.
Japan Pet Fair.
One of the biggest pet fair exhibits
in Japan. Then you were going to do Ustream show.
Yes, that's right. And that event was only postponed, and we're going to do that event again next year in March. And I think we're going to have a meeting next week, Monday, and we're going to discuss what we're going to do in the next year's event. But I think we're going to do the Ustream, definitely.
Yeah.
So I hope someone who's interested in pet industry in Japan.
Are you going to do it in English?
Oh, great.
Well, yes, I will try to do it. So please come and watch.
Maybe I should.
You should join. Yes.
Okay, yeah. Now we can. We should talk about it after the broadcast or something.
That's right.
Oh, that's right. Cool. Can I ask you, how's the business after in a month or two? It's been 3 months. How's the business after? What's the changes before and after the earthquake?
Our business was not so good before earthquake. So now it is not so good, but it means same as.
It's okay. So it hasn't changed.
It hasn't changed.
We are always poor.
like I'm always poor.
Wow.
But, how do you think about? I think I concerned about the numbers of marriage and divorce and suicide. Those numbers are changed after the earthquake, especially young people. And it's a kind of a PTSD or something.
So marriage went up?
Yes.
And the divorce went
up? Also.
And suicide went up too, yeah.
Yeah.
But marriage went up is the one of the, NHK was reporting that some psychologists talked about it on the TV, that because it's human being needs the certain safety. You know, we need first of all we need all animal needs the needs like
company.
Need for there's a step of the need of the animal. First is the food.
Yes.
Second is the where to live. And third is the
family
and making the kids for the
reproduction.
Reproduction. So increase of the marriage is that you know part of the sense of the security in order to so that's I saw the news about because more Japanese people now start thinking that they need to protect themselves by having the family to increase the size of the protection too. Then the number of the divorce, the increasing number of the divorce, I think it's also it's that why it's coming from the stress, that they were having okay relationship, but after the earthquake, it's getting more stressful. And then some stuff that the couple were able to kind of be patient it's now no longer be able to be patient. So that's why number of the divorce and also the increase. And then, you know, obviously the increasing number of the suicide is because of the you know, of course, the mental stress of the earthquake, countless number of the aftershock, countless number, and then many people lost the job, many people have to suffer, had to suffer from all the changes that we've been through. So the month of the May had the most suicide ever I heard. Naoko-san, hey Naoko-san. Naoko-san is, I also met Naoko-san a week before the earthquake too.
Living in Japan?
Yeah, they're in Japanese? Japan. Naoko-san was in our Marrying to Japanese Yokosu News Weekly show. That you can also watch our archive. So we met Naoko-san a week before the earthquake too. That was interesting. Everything kind of changed. And then, I wanted to talk to someone, but I'm kind of getting hungry. I've kind of started forgetting stuff.
Very interesting to hear statics.
Statics.
Association with the trauma.
The trauma.
Yeah, very interesting PTSD? To hear the statistics. Association associated with the trauma. Yeah. So, it's of course I'm not the scientist. You have to also watch. I need to look care more and then say, hey James, what's up? Pets can help too. Yeah, pets can help. Probably because you guys. So you were also with the pets, then that also made you the feel of the kind of comfort to withstand this disaster. You think?
But also pets can be stressed.
Oh yeah.
Yes, and some pets are traumatized or had a bad association with the urekuru. Please.
Oh yes,
the alarm,
emergency, earthquake, pre-earthquake, pre-earthquake warning system.
Yes. They had a bad association.
Yeah, we also had a bad association, and the kids too. Actually, the NHK also shows the report that you know, kids now get really traumatized by the sound of the pre-earthquake warning system.
So I recorded that melody and trained dogs
to change their association from bad to good
to the food. Yeah.
Okay. Oh, so you also
so that can be treated in a good way if one of your pets is traumatized with that precaution.
Yeah, pre-earthquake warning
system alarm. Alarm. You can retrain your dog. Food alarm.
Yeah, I trained myself to wake up when I heard the sound too. I associate the sound to my brain to wake up.
Oh yeah, that's classical conditioning. Yes. Thank you, Skinner. Yes.
So So
many people are losing a direction to live or to work. So it's a basic reason of the increased numbers of suicide. I guess. So we need hope.
Yeah, Aceman, I need to yes, you're off to work. Okay, have a good work. And then it's the walk, work direction to work. What was I gonna ask you? Oh, so yeah, then let's go to the Fukushima related stuff.
Yes.
So, because you know, I think you guys had a radioactive water in the tap water in this region.
Right now, I don't.
No. Did you ever the Yokohama City detect the radioactive contamination from the tap water?
Kawasaki, maybe. Shu-san may have some information about water pollution. Kawasaki de mizu no osen te deta tte?
Osha no.
Detenai.
Yokohama de toran na.
Yokohama mo detenai.
Tokyo itta.
Tokyo dake ya na. Tokyo
dake. Kanagawa jo. Kanagawa ichi o detenai
hazu. Ocha? Ocha pa kara deta ne.
Ocha wa ne. Ocha pa. Anyway, so what's the reaction to the people of the Yokohama, and you trained the many people from Tokyo as well. What do those people say about a safety of the food and water in Tokyo area now?
No.
I mean, back then and now. Yeah.
Well, it's almost the same thing here as in Yokohama.
Mm-hmm.
So they had some shortage of the stuff I just mentioned, and not much mention about Chiba, but the damage they had was so serious. Liquidification.
Yes.
And Gesui.
The sewage system.
Yes. Because they lost that system.
Yeah, sewage system.
They cannot wash dishes, or they cannot flush the toilet. So they had to live very uncomfortably for about 2 months or so.
That's about our school. That's some of your students.
Yes. Yes, experience. Well, that lady actually spent the night with us. The night of the earthquake.
I see.
She stayed with us, and she, after that, she couldn't come here for about 2 months, and she came back to say thank you for that night. And she mentioned about the toughness and difficulties she's having because of the liquidification in their residence.
Her house got damaged, or she's fine.
No damage in the house, but the
The sewage system.
System.
I see. Then, but how about the food safety? Do the people were afraid of the food, like vegetables?
Well, some people are very cautious, but not us. Personally, not us.
All over Japan, we should concern.
Yes.
About the radiation of fishes and vegetables.
Yes. No matter how much people say it's safe, we just cannot say it's safe. We have to present that we have to check.
Like you read one of the news from the urine test.
Because this urine test was done. Urine test to the students are not done by a government, but also the group of the parents, because they couldn't trust the government, so they conducted their own research and they found out about it. It cost about a couple thousand bucks or tens of the hundreds of thousands of yen to do those tests, but they raised the money and they did the test by themselves. But in a way, it's food safety. It's not you don't have any concern. Did you have any concern about the food safety?
Not me personally. Well, I think I should be more worried or concerned about the food.
We are old enough not concern about food.
We have more stuff to concern. Are wild or domesticated animal turned up with high rates of radiation? Around the Fukushima area, around here, we don't have any
radiation.
Right?
No.
That's what the report says, but no one has actually tested, so I don't know, official, you know.
or we haven't, we don't know about the news if they did it or not. What do you think when you heard the explosion of the hydro explosion of a Fukushima nuclear power plant, what was your reaction? Did you think that what was the people's reaction? Did people think that they had to leave the Kanto area? Like you did tell me at the ramen place that you saw some cars in the your stay.
Yeah, in Nagoya.
Yeah.
Oh.
Many people escaped with their dogs to the facility.
Uh-huh.
Yes, when we visited, we had some
event
uh-huh.
in your area,
uh-huh.
and that's yeah. why we went to his area
uh-huh.
in Mie after the
week after the earthquake.
After the earthquake, and the hotels we stayed, we could stay with our pets, dogs, and what we saw there was the many cars that are from this area, uh-huh. Kanto area. So the owner of the hotel said to us that they are here to escape from the the damage.
Yeah, I see. Many people from
try to escape.
Try to go farther away as much as they possible.
I heard from some. The foreign people, non Japanese people, try to stay away from Kanto area. Mm. Some people went back to their own countries, mm-hmm. or some people traveled to the western part of Japan
mm-hmm.
to get away from this area.
Mm.
But I think they're back now, many of them.
Mm. Maybe.
Yeah.
Because we had many earthquakes. After the disaster,
aftershocks
yes. in the all over Japan,
uh-huh.
so we yeah. couldn't find a safety place.
Yeah, that's true.
Not only Japan, but there are many earthquake in the world too.
Uh-huh.
Big earthquake or big hurricane or typhoon or
uh-huh.
something.
Natural disaster happened everywhere.
Yeah. So.
Yeah. So. Well, we just have to live with it. Next earthquake could happen in my area, which is the scientists say it's highly possible.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Already.
Tokai. Oh, well, this area too. It's this
well,
is the
it's
one.
Well, it's been said for a long time.
Yeah, long time.
This area.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
But according to this expert's report that. When this Tohoku earthquake happened, the possibility of that happening, the Tokai earthquake is, history tells like it happened within a couple years or something too.
Mm.
Yeah, so that's because.
But it's been said like that for a long time.
Yeah, no, but the big earthquake really happened already, right, in Tohoku.
Yeah.
And according to some history, the Tokai earthquake did happen within a couple years.
Really?
We'll see. Tornado. Yeah, Marco. Yeah, I heard that. I heard
tornado.
The news too. Tornado in the U.S. The yeah. So.
What state?
We always have to prepare for anything. If you don't think you have a storm problem, typhoon problem, then you might have a heat problem.
Heat problem.
Yeah. So.
Well, I think we're going to have a very, very hot summer this year.
Yeah, I think so too.
I think, well, I'm sorry about the people who live in the Tohoku area. Like you said in your Mirror News, they're having trouble
to
stay away from the heat and food poisoning.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That's getting really serious.
What did you learn from this earthquake? What did you guys
what
learn?
What did you learn?
you first.
Well, I need time to think about it. That means I didn't learn anything.
No, you learned a lot, I think. I learned a lot.
What?
Well, first of all, you know, disaster will happen.
Could be happening.
Could happen like anytime.
Anytime,
yes.
When it did happen. So yes. That I was preparing for that, you know, so, and it, you know, then I was lucky, but, you know, I was, it was far away, so my area didn't shake that much. Mm. So people who are standing up didn't even feel the shake, but I happened to be sitting down and then working, and I felt the shake. Oh, what's that? Mm. Then I turned on the NHK news, and then they were showing the breaking news. Mm. So I was able to get the information of the earthquake ASAP. Mm. Mm. But you know, what else? Yeah, I mean, it was 6 minutes after the earthquake happened, but it was like 10 seconds after it shook my area too. Mm. So I was able to report that. Mm. But you know, so I was lucky, but somehow I was preparing to do a disaster broadcast. So and then.
What did I learn?
Anyway, prepare. Disaster happen at any time, and you just have to prepare
place.
And then expect for like unexpected stuff to happen. You know, like every time when the huge disaster happen, no matter how much you prepare, or you know. Unexpected stuff happen, no matter what. Mm. Mm. But you know, again, like you let one of the students stay overnight. Mm. We were kind of able to prepare in a way, you know, think more carefully. Mm. Many people then, you know, in Tokyo area, many people couldn't go back home. Then many places open up their building to let the people stay, sleep over the first night.
Mm. I thought at the same time people were more generous than I expected.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Yeah.
Maybe I mentioned that on the Skype broadcasting. But we had the scheduled blackout. And at that time, all the traffics were, you know, please go ahead, please go ahead. That's what everyone did. Usually, when the truck, you know, the normal life. I want to go
people
fast.
Are rude.
Fast.
Yeah, people used to be rude.
rude. But I thought.
But people became more generous.
Be generous.
Yes. Mm. James, hurricane season has started. Always try to prepare with water, food, candles.
Candles. Yes, candles are very important.
Yeah.
I think that's one of the things we learned, and how much we relied on the electricity. Yes.
Mm. Oh yeah, we always talked about the electricity. Life. Did you have a scheduled blackout here?
No.
Not here, but my area.
Oh, okay.
Yes, that's why I had the signal blackout.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, so you didn't have to worry about. What do you think about the conserving the energy? Are you conserving energy right now?
Yes, you started.
I said solar system.
Yes.
And oh really?
Big batteries.
Oh really?
Yes. That was fun. Yes.
He makes the Kazu-san makes a great tool like. He made these lights that he set it up for this broadcast, which I wasn't expected to. And somehow I have a sound guy, which I didn't expect to have. Somehow I have a camera guy who's operating the camera, which I didn't expect to. Oh my god. Oh my god. That's why I'm good. I'm sorry, guys. That's the one of the reasons we were a little bit late, but it's okay. But anyway,
So yes, about this, the candles. Uh-huh. I thought we rely too much on the electricity. Mm-hmm. So without electricity, we had no lights. Mm-hmm. You know, it was so natural for us to just turn on the switch, and then the everything comes here. We didn't have any heater. No, heater. Mm-hmm. All we had was air conditioning operated by the electricity, TEPCO. And the only thing we had as a heater was the gas operated one. But that's the only thing. Mm-hmm. Without that gas one, we had no heat. Mm. So that maybe we had to spend in the very, you know, the freezing cold.
Yeah, when this even happened in wintertime, yes. More colder. I mean, it was cold for the first couple, you know, but...
So always be prepared with some source of the energy. Mm-hmm. So that's one thing I have learned.
Mm, cool. So can I ask you a little bit sensitive question?
What is it?
Do you still think we need the nuclear power plant? No? Why?
Oh, it's too difficult to explain in English I think, but...
I think you can say in Japanese and then Katz will translate.
Just simply I should say that we as people should go back to the basic. Uh-huh. So the reproduction things, we losing babies in Japan. Uh-huh. So average 1.3 baby children per
household.
It means losing population. So I think
we should care more. We should think before we start talking about the nuclear power plant, whether we should all go back to the fundamental of the base, which you think that there's more than energy, that more fundamentals you have to start. But I'm talking, I want to talk about the nuclear power plant itself, though.
Yeah.
But so what do you think?
Some people say that we need nuclear power plant. It means otherwise we cannot keep those culture or comfortable life. But no one had electricity long time ago. So I think we should think as how many can we have without nuclear power plant? And with those electricity, how can we live comfortably? That's the direction of our think. So we shouldn't think as a keep this life.
We have to come up with the alternative life, not only just to save the energy power, but or you know, so we should
so return to so basic.
But do you want so you think you don't need nuclear power plant?
No.
Okay, got it. How about you?
No.
So would you pay more expensive electricity?
No.
No, I would like to pay less.
But we can save electric.
Okay.
Yeah. So.
And I think by being more creative, you know, thinking about life without nuclear power, you know, generation system, we could have something different in less expensive and less, you know, danger, but with more fun.
Office and in a swimming pool.
Yeah, so be
pool office.
Yes, and that may boost up some economy too.
I want swimming pool office too, but I think it's dangerous to touch the keyboard with the wet hands.
Oh, yeah. Well, be creative. You know, the waterproof keyboard. PC will make some,
Yeah, maybe Apple has to make a waterproof laptop.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
Yeah, so. I don't live in Tokyo area, so I'm not the typical customer. But you are a typical customer. Typical customer, what is your reaction?
How do you think?
Typical customer?
Yeah, as a typical customer, what do you think about TEPCO right now?
We don't like to fight with someone, but I don't like this situation. So.
Well, I don't have
Do you feel like a TEPCO deceive you by telling you guys that the nuclear power plant is safe, that we need to have more nuclear power plant? Did you guys?
Well, I don't think, I don't think they wanted to deceive us. They believe. I mean, someone told them that this is safe. So they just followed what they were told. I mean, I don't know who they are, but I think we all should ask ourselves. Is this really good? Is this really, you know, what we needed, or what we need? Or finding out the truth by ourselves is important. So I don't have any, you know, my personally have any negative feeling about TEPCO company itself, because TEPCO is not a, you know, a person. There is someone in there who's responsible for something important should tell us the truth, but that's not TEPCO itself. The TEPCO, the employees of TEPCO have some, you know, difficulties, some troubles by just working in the company. I feel sorry for them.
But the bureaucracy, according to some independent journalist, what's the name? What's the Tachibana-san? According to Tachibana-san, I mean, TEPCO bureaucracy system itself is corrupt. That means TEPCO itself as an organization, it's not. But. What do you think we want TEPCO to become?
Well,
improve.
Well, yes, please.
I think many small electric companies will establish to make a local area electric systems. And TEPCO will be a kind of a distributor or management company.
So you want to make the electricity market to be free market. Then TEPCO should be just a distributor.
Like a NTT.
So yeah, like a telecommunication company NTT, which makes infrastructure, like fiber optics, internet, and the internet service provider use NTT's network, then provide their own service. Okay.
And I wish I make my electric system like a solar system,
By yourself?
Mm.
So you spend a whole day, like, you know, building up your own solar system in the office.
not here, but it's the best way to,
that's
to make themselves, our own
power generating system at home.
So you think, so the what your answer is, TEFCO should be maybe just a distributor. Infrastructure like NTT's that. Internet fiber optic infrastructure in Japan,
like that.
That's really interesting idea. Then everybody could, any company could become a power generator. Then
like a SoftBank, is one of a big electric, new electric company. They can make a new company.
I see. So how about you? What you want TEFCO to do or improve or what?
To improve? Well, again, it's not to do with TEFCO, but the bureaucracy system about Japan. That's something I want. I want some change in.
Okay.
There. Yes.
Okay.
You know, we used to explain about dogs. Instinct part. If you cannot control dog's instinct, then you should close the door to let dogs know that they have a big potential for aggressive behavior. It's like a nuclear power plant. So we shouldn't handle nuclear until we can do that in space, out of the Earth. Otherwise, we cannot control. Too dangerous.
I see.
So it's same as like a border collie's instinct. Herding instinct. It's too dangerous for beginners. Same as that.
Well, sounds good. Sounds good. Okay, everyone, this is Katz from Yokoso News, yokosonews.com. Yokoso News is the online website to introduce Japan in English so that you can understand Japan more. Since March 11th, I've been broadcasting weekly disaster emergency livecast to give you the latest information of Fukushima nuclear power plant incident and Tohoku North Japan earthquake tsunami update. This week, I'm here at the Yokohama, Japan, DINGO, the training certificate facility, the Club Pero, to inviting the Kazu-san, the founder of DINGO, Mika-san, the partner of the DINGO, and the Luft, he's sleeping. He's sleeping.
Luft.
Yay. He's sleepy, I think.
Yes.
Sleepy.
Cats and Roses, did you know German government decided to quit nuclear power plant?
Yeah, because of Fukushima. Yes, Cats and Roses. Yes, we know. We all know.
Yes.
And then Tatiana Katz, you think living in Aichi and general in Chubu is dangerous? What about food? No, we don't have any danger except Shizuoka's tea is the part that's part of the Shizuoka is considered part of the Chubu. So they found the more than 100 becquerel per 500 becquerel per kilogram of the cesium from the some of the green tea. So in a way, but according to Japanese government, it is still like okay. So especially it's just tea leaves, you know, when you drink it, it's going to be scattered, you know, so it's going to be much less than 500 becquerel per kilogram. So according to Japanese government, according to Shizuoka prefecture, the Shizuoka's green tea is safe. So if based on that report, no Japanese media, no Japanese scientist are saying that the food is in Chubu area is dangerous yet. James, thermal is the next best in IMHO. Solar and the wind still isn't the truly cost effective. Next best time. And then Naoko posted the map. Thank you. And then did you know? Yeah, then the Cats and Roses. Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm. Marco, thank you very much. Great show. No, you guys rock because of the audience. Without the audience, we couldn't do it without it. Annette, okay, you have to go work, Annette. Good luck with your work, Annette, in Sweden.
Oh, yes, that's right.
So yes. It's in the morning.
So she's got to go work.
She has to work.
Yes, please have a great day.
Yeah.
It's 4 o'clock, almost 4 o'clock in Japan. Mm. Yes. The afternoon. Mm.
It's curry time.
Cat is very hungry.
Yeah, I am. So let's start wrapping up. Do you guys have any question on the social timeline? And I will take some answer. But so we are here at the DINGO. If you want to become a professional dog trainer,
oh my god,
you should come to DINGO. And actually, they are the worldwide. This is the world headquarters of DINGO. They have a trainer in the United States, Canada, Taiwan, Wales,
Hong Kong, Singapore, Mexico, and Thai right now.
Thailand. They're developing the Thailand location. Mm. Oh, Annette, it's 8 a.m. in Sweden. So it's 3:48 p.m. Japan Standard Time right now. Mm. Anywhere in Europe?
No.
Okay, they are looking for some collaborator in Europe too.
Yes.
And it's great click training system that they have. You can actually check Pets in Japan, our archive, from Yokoso News to check what is their click training method. It's very interesting. Clicker method.
Yeah, clicker method.
So,
Bird training.
And bird training too. Mm. Yes, if you want to train your birds, please come visit me. Yes, I've got 2 capitals now.
And you are
agility.
Can I say that you are writing the book?
Actually,
making a DVD.
Bird training.
Bird training.
I wrote a book of clicker training.
Okay, clicker training. Yeah, so.
So we're producing the bird training birds.
So
DVD.
Yeah. So that's the reason why I'm doing this weekly broadcast, because I was here 4 days before the earthquake.
Yes.
And then now I'm here because I had a music charity concert 2 days ago. And then since I'm here in Tokyo, maybe I stay extra couple days to visit all the people who I met before the earthquake. And then ask around what's happening in Kanto area as well. To tell you guys that what's the reaction of the honest reaction of the people in the local. But you know, whenever I talk to someone, I'm not going to say who, but many people start feeling that it's not safe to drink tap water anymore. Some of the people in Tokyo, they used to use the tap water to cook and stuff too, but they no longer use any tap water. So the people don't say it because people say that Japanese government, Japanese media also keep saying that it's just a rumor. It's not true. So we shouldn't be scared too much. Japanese people in Tokyo area understands that, so they don't want to say it. But in their real heart, they're still. I still have a feeling that many people in Kanto area are still scared of the radiation. Anyway.
Yeah, me myself, I don't care because I'm old enough. But for our dogs, we concerned about the tap water. So we put RO filtering system, mm-hmm. which bought from United States, mm-hmm. and this is perfect. I mean, more than 98% of radiation are stopped by those filter.
Okay. Okay. Cool. So people are still scared in Tokyo area too. In addition to Fukushima, people are scared too. So that's it.
Serious.
So everyone, so I'm gonna start wrapping up the show, and then
James. He's got a dog question.
Yeah. My brother have
a half timber wolf puppy. How to handle its aggression? Well, it's gonna be a long story. Yes. Find me in the Facebook, and we can be friends, and we can talk more.
Mika Ishiwata.
Mika, M-I-K-A.
Well, you should have a Facebook page now.
Me?
Dingo.
Well, Dingo, too. Not as a Dingo.
No.
No.
But our website starts from English page.
Yeah, so. dingo.gr.jp.
Yes.
You should go to dingo.gr.jp, and you can get more information there. And then, yeah.
Mori-san is here.
Okay, we have some visitor. So 8 p.m. next show, 8 p.m.
Yes, soon. And also they can find me in the Facebook.
Yeah. And then so.
なんだっけゲームの名前。友達になってって言えばいいんだ。
そうだ。
ね。Now Mika is playing a game of Facebook.
Yeah,
how do you say?
Well, that's what the cats used to play a lot, but I have no friends.
Oh, the City Vile.
I'm
looking for a friend. I'm looking for some friends. And also some army, like war. I don't know how to pronounce it.
なんだっけ?
Start from Z. Like Z. Zigna Ali something.
It's a name of the company.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Well, yes.
Anyway.
Yeah. Anyway, so you can come to Ding. I just made that stuff.
Oh,
dingo.gr.jp. Animal training certificate that you can get. And then, you know.
We know many good instructors in United States too,
yes.
And the friends in Wolf Park.
Yes, mm-hmm. That's right. Mm. Yes.
Mm. So, cool. And then, so everyone, this is Kat from Yokoso News, yokosonews.com. Yokoso News is the online website. Then we are doing the number 43 of a 311 disaster weekly update. 2 days ago, I did the charity concert. I broadcast the charity concert to the event. It's called Music for Charity for Miyagi. And then we are still accepting the donation, and you can still watch the archive.
Okay.
This broadcast archive will go to the YouTube, and when you, in you know, and but. Now it's really the time to focus on the North Japan, and I really want to continue this coverage. So I really love to start needing your support. So I want to start raise some money to go continue the coverage of North Japan. So if you like what we do. And if you make a certain amount of the donation, I'm thinking about giving you something too. Which I haven't decided what it is. But I'm too busy to. I was too busy for the concert to think about. But anyway, we are working with a great city church, Tokyo, which sent the bus every week to North Japan, and we are trying to do lots of stuff. So enjoy the music that's in the archive, and if you like what we do, and please make a contribution. If you like to contribute in other than monetary contribution, you can tell other people to keep paying attention to the North Japan. I mean, of course, the world has all other issues that we need to pay attention to. But, you know, just still keep in mind that people in North Japan still suffering and stuff too. All right. So, everyone, thank you very much for watching. It's thank you very much for watching the show today. That's Lufto.
Lufto.
Hello. Lufto. I'm sleepy. Nemutai.
Good.
Then Kazu-san from DINGO, the founder of DINGO. Mika-san from Mika-san from Mika-san from Mika-san from the partner. Then you can find more information at dingo.gr.jp. It's a dog training. They offer dog training in the DINGO system. Then they do all over the world, and they're now looking for the European
partners,
yes. I think. And then, so that's pretty much it.
Now we're moving to curry.
Yes, let's go move to the curry. So, but anyway, thank you very much for watching. The today's show has been broadcasted. But first of all, I thought I was just going to do the stable camera.
Mm.
Just sit on the tripod. No zoom out, no zoom in.
We have good friend.
Yeah, so we have so a professional
cameraman.
He is the one of the best study cam operator in Japan. Yes. No, I know he's shaking his face, but I believe he is or he will be in 10 years.
Yes.
So I mean he's going to be Japan's the best steady cam operator. He may not be, but he will be in about 10 years. And then Hugh-san, he also took care of our live cast 2 days ago. Thank you very much, Hugh-san. I didn't ask these two people to help me, and I didn't ask you to put me the lights. I think we should have saved the power though.
Yeah.
But Kazu-san made a nice floor lens light and stuff. So.
Oh, we have a comment to you too.
Yeah.
Thank you, technical staff too.
Yeah.
Thank you. Yes.
Yeah, thank you.
技術の方にもお礼が。
So, all right, cool. So it has been the Yokos News 311 disaster update number 43 special from Yokohama, Japan.
Yes.
Our next live cast is on July 10th. Enka music show.
Wow.
Enka.
From Yokkaichi Mie, Japan. So I think it's 8 p.m. on July 10th, but I have to make a confirmation with the Cosmo Gakki. But we will do the Enka live music show,
Japanese,
I think.
Soul music?
Yep. Blues.
Wow.
Enka.
Blues music.
Blues.
Yes. Wow. That's coming up on July 10th. This coming Sunday on July 10th. So that's, don't miss it. And that's pretty much it. So thank you very much for watching. And no more question, right? Okay, no more question on the social timeline, right? Oh, by the way, yesterday I was on the Japanese Ustream show called Used Today. More than
famous one
among the Japanese. It's in Japanese. I explained to people that what I was doing on the disaster programming, and then you know, they like what I do. So I'm, you know, hopefully Japanese people also wanted
to.
You're
the pride of Japan.
So everyone, so thank you very much for watching, and I will see you on July 10th. Enka Cosmo Shamisen Love. It's the Enka special. All right. Thank you. Bye bye.